experience all the heart-pounding suspense of this first two-man space probe, traveling more than 71 million astro miles toward Mars.
On the set, people would come in, and we were kind of an oddity. What is it these guys are shooting, you know? Paul's dressed up like Robin Hood in space.
Nobody knew who the hell we were anyway.
We were.
I was totally unknown except to my parents, you know.
Yeah. And I didn't even know him some days, you know. But anyway, no. We...
He used to date one of my ex-wives, I remember that.
Oh, that was funny.
Me before Diane.
English, used to date English Diane. Gal?
Yeah, English gal. Neurotic English gal with great legs.
With what?
With great legs.
Yeah, that's... I remember the neuroticism.
Oh, me more. Too. Me too. If I saw her... If I saw her coming at me today, I'd jump under a fucking bus, I'll tell you.
Anyway.
So that Animal Actors of Hollywood, Mona? Animal Actors of Hollywood, where'd they get the monkey?
No. A trainer by the name of...
Court Sheridan.
Court Sheridan. And he and they took a chance. There was only one monkey. You know, they shoot Lassie or whatever. They have right, like right. 20 of them. There was one monkey. And...
The stand-in, though, he had a stand-in monkey.
Oh, yeah?
He was a real gnarly bitch. Barney was
Wait a minute. Are you talking about my ex-wife?
Probably.
I'm kidding. No. Anyway, so I'll never forget, it was like the first or second day back at the studio when we came back from Death Valley, and this group of women came in, and they were like Pasadena type, you know, like in the old Marx Brothers films, you know. Oh, we're here to see what you're shooting, you know. And so Barney, if he got scared, he would poop. Or if he wasn't pooping, he was playing.
I think I still got some on my shoulder.
So anyway, I usually, when somebody was around, would hold his hands so he did not embarrass the situation. So these women were saying, "What is it y'all shooting, you know, young man?" And I said, "Well, we're shooting a space picture." And Barney is going like this, and he's moving like this. And she's so arrogant, you know, that I let his hand go. He's going like this.
Barney the monkey?
Yeah, he's going like this, and I'm bouncing. And I'm looking at her, she's going like this. She said, "Well, I think I have to go."
I thought it was Mona.
It was in the movie. But it was.
Oh, okay.
They made a little fur jockstrap.
But
and it became Mona.
I learned the hard way about Tom.
But sweet as a cocker spaniel. What a sweetheart.
Barney had loose balls when they rang the bell. See, the assistant director would ring the bell, quiet on the set, ring, 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 ring.
Boing, and that was it.
So every time, I'm walking around the set, always like this, watching for the assistant director. You could talk to me, I wouldn't even pay attention to you. You're getting ready to shoot, and the minute he goes away to the bell, I went back to this.
You got shit on. What about me with the spacesuit? Climbing the mountains in Death Valley.
Oh, yeah?
He was terrified that I'd slip, and he would go, that's it, all right, cut. Change the monkey, change the astronaut.
Yeah, the kid, I think, is in diapers on.
Oh. He had diapers.
Listen, did you know that if Paul had the right agent and representative and PR person, this guy carried this movie with the monkey, not stealing the movie.
We carried the movie. Barney carried the movie. Okay. We did a good job, though.
He was in the first, 45 minutes?
Something like that. And then he spoiled everything.
Then
I spoiled everything, right. Gave a performance.
Listen, 64. Robinson Crusoe on Mars was just released. And our director, Byron Haskins, called me in to come to Paramount to meet him and Gene Roddenberry. And they said, Paul, they called you in too, but being that I look kind of weird and I have these funny ears, Byron said I'd be great for a part. And I said, "Well, great, I'm all ears, you know."
You mean they've escaped? I swear, no one was at fault. The guards, 10 of them, were constantly on duty watching the cell. Then when we opened it to give them food, they simply weren't there, and there was no way out.
you're lying to me.
I swear.
All right, Lieutenant.
Yeah, and Gene met with me and Byron, and there was the part of Spock. And they had these little funny ears, and they wanted me to put them on. And, you know, I kind of tried them on.
Right, right.
I was thinking to myself, all right, what kind of thing is this, you know? But I was all smiles. And then they at the last second, they decided that the, was it Hunter? What was his first name? The actor who played in the pilot. He was killed, fell down.
Oh, Jeffrey Hunter.
Jeff Hunter, right.
He was the first.
Spock?
No, he was the first commander.
Was he?
Yeah, and Shatner replaced him.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Come on, Paul. You didn't know that?
No. I'm not a Trekkie. I'm not a.
He played Commander Pike, they call him.
Oh, that's really? Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so Jeffrey Hunter was the first commander in the pilot.
Mm-hmm.
But then the pilot, they wanted them to redo it. And then Byron called me and he said, look, I want you to do Spock, but the studio feels that you're a little too buff. Because I was, well, you saw. Anyway. And Jeffrey Hunter.
You're beautiful, Vic. That's why I wanted you on Mars.
Yes.
Beautiful companion.
That was great.
Didn't talk much, though.
That guy who didn't have soap.
No, I had a big slap him and keep him talking.
Yeah, anyway. So, didn't get the part, but I came in second, so they say.
You were second, huh? Really?
That was history, yeah. And Leonard is smaller.
Mm-hmm.
And they thought I overpowered Jeffrey Hunter.
You worked with Leonard on, Mission Impossible, right?
No.
Or was that earlier than that?
No, he was in that Star Trek.
No, you were in Mission Impossible.
Yes, a couple of times.
Yeah.
Really? So you worked with Leonard anyway.
Did Tom Grice direct you in that?
No, and many other things.
Danny, you looked good with the years.
Tommy was great. You know? He stuck me in everything he possibly could.
Tom was too young.